Hey guys, welcome back to another one. Today we're going to be talking about some mid-season trapping prices for fur coming forward from this time in December and going forward. These prices are coming from TrapperMag.com, which has given us an early December look into the fur prices and what we can expect going forward. Don't forget to like this video and subscribe to Outdoor Experiences. Every interaction that you have on our channel helps us out. And now back to today's video. The global fur market is currently not as good as we would like. COVID-19 has reduced consumer confidence, constrained the movements of consumers, and in return, lowered retail store visits. Because of this, garment sales have been low and business in China, the top fur market, is low. Health precautions and sanitary measures cause manufacturing delays and creates a backlog of skins, which decreases the need for fresh skins and creates lower prices. To make the long story short, the outlook for fur prices remains the same as last year, if not a slight decrease. Despite this depressing outlook, western coyotes and castor glands from beavers have actually been a bright spot. The best western coyotes should continue to come in above the 100 to 150 mark. A step down from the best could bring in $60 to $80. Coarser and darker eastern pelts should be bringing $30 to $40. Odd colors and unprimed skins will remain tough to sell as the trimming market for coyotes is slowly degrading after some key companies, such as Canada Goose, slowly abandon coyote fur for other options. If you have coyotes, sell them and take what you can, as this market is likely fading away in the next few years, unless other things pop up. The current market situation for coyotes also tells you to wait for fully primed skins. Since the price difference may be $30 to $50 for the same animal caught too early versus fully primed. Castor glands are likely to fetch more from large beaver carcasses than their respective pelts. Beaver fur will barely hit the $10 mark, but a good set of castor glands may bring in more than the $10 at current prices of $80 to $110 per pound. When you must trap beavers to fill quotas, obtain bait, or to help landowners or forestry companies, remember to keep the castor glands. Skin the very best pelts, but do not expect much from small beavers or the pelts with bite marks. With raccoons, extra large and fully primed skin should be your goal. Blue pelts or anything with damage will not cover the skinning costs. The best strategy for raccoons is to wait as long as you can and try to target those boars traveling to their winter shelters. Raccoon pelts store fairly well, and many of the current buying is done on speculation. This means that buyers purchase top skins at ridiculously low prices, hoping to make a profit when the market rebounds. It may happen someday, but not within the next 2 to 3 years, that is estimated. Raccoons, although abundant and fun to catch, are definitely not profit items to target this year. Up north, martens and fishers are key animals for some trap lines. But this year, again, there will be no profit in them. Fishers sold at $15 to $20 last year and martens $20 to $50, with most trappers obtaining averages below $40. In the lower 48, marten prices will not even reach the $20 mark. Canada lynx also may only bring in $50 to $60 for the very best pelts. Muskrats should be okay to sell at the $3 to $5 average. And catch them when they are prime, because low quality pelts cost the same to tan and process as good pelts, so buyers will seek the better skins. Wild mink will bring in no more than a good muskrat, and river otters will fetch $15 to $20 on average, with exceptional pelts exceeding $30. Red foxes continue to be difficult to sell, and most buyers offer $10 to $12 per pelt. Wild cross and silver foxes are much easier to sell and usually bring in twice the price of a good red fox. Make sure to consider alternative markets if you catch something exceptional. Taxidermists often like to mount cross foxes, albino animals, and or animals with unusual markings, fishers with extensive white patches, martens with exceptional orange throat patch, things like that. In conclusion, alternative markets are a good idea for trappers. Now is the time to tan furs for your own use, for wall hangers, and to sell for friends and family. This method could double the price for a raw skin. Tan skins also make great gifts. We do have a video on this if you want to learn how to home tan as well to cut some more price off of it. Thank you for watching this episode of Outdoor Experiences. Please like and share the video. If you have any questions about this video or about trapping in general, feel free to leave a comment below and we'll do our best to respond. We also have a Discord server in which you can share your catches and ask questions. There are affiliate links below in which you can buy the equipment that we use in our videos. Thanks again for watching, and we'll catch you on the next one.